Hi guys, E3 Locks here. Reading through on the forums lately, and the subject of Brahmas came up, and it was mentioned by a couple. I think that they don't actually ever see them, or they've never seen one. So I thought what I'd do is I'd take one apart and show you it. So this isn't a picking video, it's literally just all about Brahmas. First thing with the Brahma is, I say, you might look at this and think, oh, this one here is an old one because it's got flathead screws in it. But when you think that Brahmas have been around for some sort of 330 years, they actually make this one here a baby. Which will probably make this one, which is one of the latest ones, sort of like still the sperm swimming towards the egg. The work on the same principle. They've got 7 sliders in them, and there's a spring. The key, you can see that was, you have to push it down, and I'll show you the spring on it. Hopefully you can see this. So bring it round, try and get the spring out. Yeah, so it's actually jumped straight out. If you did want to pick one of these, what you'd have to do is sort of make yourself a tension tool, something along these lines, and then use like a bobby pin to actually go down, push the sliders down, and then be able to actually hook under them and pick them back up if you need be. Very much on the principle of an H lever on an ASEC or a leggy, sort of that same sort of principle. Now, we're going to look at the lock. First thing you notice is it weighs far, far more than any other lock, sort of a comparable size. And you'll see why. And I've just turned it onto the side. I think you can see that. You can actually see the size of the hard plates. I mean, I don't think there's another hard plate anywhere near as thick as that. Okay. And these really are quite an amazing lock. All right, what I'll do is take the first one apart. With old locks, I never use a battery on them, because obviously I want to prefer the keep the screws original as well. So it's 4 screws holding it in, and to be honest with you, when you take a Bramah apart, you can really take a Bramah apart, which is what I'll show you. If we take that off, first one off, that's the hard plate, say. And it shows us the 2 locking mechanisms. Obviously the first one on that side, and then the second one which would be over on that side. Now what we're going to try and do is lift off this one. If I've done the right side, it should lift off. Alright, it's come off complete. And there's your actual locking mechanism. I'll try and line this up so you can see on the video. There's a bolt there, and if you notice, these have got flat sides. It's the flat sides that allows this part to actually travel past. If you've got two round sides, that can't force its way back. Now there is a story, I don't know if it's an urban myth or not, that Bramah actually put one of these into an industrial press and compressed it to try and force that back through, and the lock exploded outwards prior to it actually giving. And when you actually look at it being solid metal, you'd probably think, yeah, it's right. What we're going to do now is just take one of these apart. Now, this just lifts off. Okay, that's a ring there. What I'm trying to do is making sure that you can see from the camera, because I'm working at a bit of an angle here. That's obviously your cam that turns this. And that should just lift out. That's it. Now, and there is your locking mechanism. Hopefully you can see that with your sliders. Let's just move that to one side. If I just put a spring in, yeah. You can see from that, obviously, how springy that is. And what we'll do is we'll strip this right down. First thing we'll do is take out this bottom slider here, which is a driver, which is always a number 2. So if you ever are going to go and pick these, you've only really got 6 sliders to pick. Put that down. Now this silver bit around the outside, that in effect is what the bolt stump is. Because when, as you can see this, you've got a slider, I don't know if you can see that. Right. Obviously the big gate, that's the true gate, and the little gate is the false gate. Now, so the driver is always a number 2. A number 4 has got no false notch in it. A 1, 2 and a 3 has the false notch at the bottom, a 5, 6 and a 7 has the false notch at the top. Okay. So what we'll do now is just carry on going around taking out these sliders. Literally all you have to do is just push them out. All I'm using the tweezers here. It's fiddly. And so what you do when you're picking with a bobby pin, so you can push them down, but then you can actually get your bobby pin under the bottom if need be and pull it back up. And these sliders are made of two tiny bits of metal. I'll try and show you. Let's come out of sequence, that one. And I've got that one left. Still got one in there, but I should be able to take one half of that off. It should come off as well now. It goes like that. I've just got the last slider in there. There it is, there it comes out. That goes there. And taking the middle bit out, that just comes out. And then you've got your spring. So there's only one spring in the lock, and then you've got your centre pin, which if you notice moves. So if people try and drill the centre spring, it will actually bounce around and could take your drill bits out. These can be drilled as well, like all locks, but that's the actual lock stripped down. If there's any, I'll tell you some bit more about it. It's not stripped down at all actually. Take the bolt out, you can see the size of that. Do this now. See this? You've got the two big screws there. When you say that you take a Bramah apart, you really do take a Bramah apart. Oh, springs just gone because that comes off, and bolt comes out. The other side. Try and keep as much of this on camera as I can. Sorry about that. So you actually take, in effect, the whole of the lock you can take apart, so any part of it can be got by itself. So that's the lock. When you go to put it back together again, just make sure with these bit that the actual gate, when you put them back together, is at the bottom where the driver pin is. I hope you enjoyed, and say if some of you haven't seen it before, I hope it's interesting, not too boring. And if there's any questions on it you want to ask better, just let us know on the forum. If I can't answer it, I'm sure someone there can. Cheers, SE3. Cheers.